I have a series of videos on different fuel additives where I have used them, discussed their content, and in some cases I have got noteworthy results with them. This video is in similar lines where I got to experiment with the Shell V-Power, the premium fuel from Shell, during my 3000 km drive to Gujarat and back. For this experiment, multiple fuel efficiency tests were done with fuels from different brands. We will also try to look inside the combustion chamber to notice any difference. All of this will be followed by an emission test where the engine will be fueled by Shell V-Power to check if we get to see any change in values. Now, before diving deep into the technical discussion, I would like to share my experience with the drive and response from the engine which was fueled by V-Power. The car did almost 1000 plus kilometers with V-Power, but the initial kilometers were done with regular fuel from Bharat Petroleum and Indian Oil. To be honest, if you are driving inside this city, you won't notice much difference between the regular fuel and the premium fuel, and the response is kind of same. But I could sense the difference on open highways, where the response was better with V-Power. The K12 engine from Suzuki did felt a bit more enthusiast and smooth over 3500 RPM. I guess it's the Dynaflex formulation in the V-Power that claims to reduce friction in the fuel touch points. But that's it. I didn't notice anything else that should need a special mention here. Now, coming to the efficiency test, well, I started the drive with a tank full of regular fuel from Reliance, which did 587.9 km, before I did the next tank full at a Bharat Petroleum station, where the tank gulped 31.28 liters of regular petrol. This brings the efficiency calculation for Reliance at 587.9 km with 31.28 liters of fuel. That equals to 18.97 km per liter of efficiency. Now, with this tank full of fuel from Bharat Petroleum, we did 643.4 km that took us all the way till Junagadh, where we did a tank full at an Indian Oil petrol pump with 35.70 liters of regular fuel. Which means the car covered 643.4 km with 35.70 liters of petrol, giving us an efficiency of 18.02 km per liter. The next 537 kilometers were spent in exploring Somnath and Dwarka, video links for which can be found in the description. From here after, we just continued with Shell V-Power in Gujarat. The first tankful was done near Rajkot. The tankful was done with 32.27 liters of V-Power, which gave us the efficiency number for Indian Oil Petrol. So 537.1 kilometers with 32.27 liters of regular Indian Oil Petrol gave us the efficiency of 16.64 kilometers per liter. Now with the Shell V-Power, we did 494 kilometers from Rajkot, Ahmedabad, Vadodara till our next Shell fuel station in Bharuch, where the tank was again fully replenished with 27.93 liters of V-Power again. So this time the V-Power gave us an efficiency of 17.70 kilometers per liter. Now with the V-Power from the Shell bunk at Bharuch, I did 556.5 kilometers and the tank was again filled after I did the emission test with 32.55 liters of fuel from Reliance. That gave the V-Power an efficiency of 17.09 kilometers per liter. So this should be clear in my case that with more than 1000 plus kilometers with V-Power, the efficiency numbers remained more or less same when compared to regular unleaded petrol. Now coming to deposits, the V-Power claims to have cleansing additives that helps in cleaning the deposits from injectors and intake. Now my car was running absolutely fine with no hiccups, injectors or fueling issues. So the only place which was possible for me to check the deposit buildup was the piston head. I personally did not find much difference on the piston top when compared to the conditions before the drive. In fact, it's a good sign that even 3000 km of running did not make much difference in terms of deposition. Of course, this is just a visual inspection, which in fact works well for the spark plugs, where the brownish electrode tip is a giveaway sign of good combustion, plus the electrode tip looks fairly clean with no unusual deposits or fouling sign. The emission test is next, and the one you're seeing on the screen is with regular fuel. And as it can be seen, the carbon monoxide, hydrocarbon emission, and the carbon dioxide values are under the limit. Now we have the emission values with the same engine running on Shell V-Power. The first thing which I noticed was no CO, that is no carbon monoxide emission at idle RPM, which is really a good thing for Shell V-Power and also for the environment. Also, the lambda value has slightly dropped from 1.03 to 1, which is a good thing in terms of stoichiometry. On the other hand, we can also see some rise in the HC values with the V power. Restall is fine with no signs of NOx emissions in both the cases. I cannot give an assurance on the calibration of the exhaust gas analyzer, but both the before and after tests were done from the same PUC center. All this brings us to the verdict, and as per my experience, there isn't a day and night difference with the general performance of Shell V-Power. And with today's video, it should be clear that with the premium price, you shouldn't be looking at this just for fuel economy. Going by my past experience with other Shell products which were actually good, I would like to believe in the cleanliness claims of V-Power and moreover the fun I experienced with it at high RPMs. You can experiment with this on your highway drives, and if you do, don't forget to share your experience in the comment section. So that's it for this video, and I hope you guys have liked it.